Hello, my name is Masha Nuts and I make friendship bracelets videos right here on YouTube. I've been making friendship bracelets for the past 12 years. I just needed to count there. And I still struggle with my alphas. I have gotten really good at them. I'm not going to downplay my achievements in alphas, but I have struggled with them for ages and I'm still not 100% happy with how that's turning out. My edges tend to sort of wiggle around a bit, but I am working on it. In any case, I feel like I have a lot to share in terms of alpha bracelets and how to make them better. I did do a Not With Me video a few months ago on which I made a huge wall hanging and I gave you guys a bunch of tips on how to make your alphas better. I'm going to be reiterating a lot of what I said there, but I'm also going to be adding a bunch of stuff onto that. So if you want extra content on the same topic, you can also watch that Not With Me video, which will be linked in the card and in the description. You can also watch my tutorial on how to make alphas and wall hangings specifically. Both of those videos are going to be linked in the description as well. But today I want to talk to you about practical things that I have found that help me in making my alpha bracelets. Let's get into it with the example that I have in front of me. So as I mentioned, I am making a wall hanging, and if you want the pattern to this, I'll leave it in the description, as I always do. Going into this video, I assume that you already know how to make alphas, and you're already quite experienced with that. As I mentioned in the intro, you can watch my tutorial on alphas if you feel like you need it, but I just want to make it clear that these tips that I'm giving are for people who already know how to make alphas and just want to improve on the techniques that they already use. So let's start talking. You may know that I actually made two tutorials on how to make alpha bracelets. If you are new and just starting out, I would recommend you entirely skip the first video that I did and only focus on the second tutorial that I made, which is the flat alpha tutorial. I honestly believe that the flat alpha technique is much better to use in making bracelets. It results in flatter bracelets, neater bracelets, and more cohesive bracelets where it also helps the edges be straight. So if you haven't already seen that, I definitely recommend you check that out. That honestly helped me a lot once I figured out how to use that technique. Another thing that I found helpful is starting in a straight line. As you can see, I started a wall hanging here, I started on a dowel and I started in a straight line. I also already mentioned this, I have a tutorial specifically on how to make wall hangings and how to attach strings to a dowel, but you don't have to make a wall hanging to start in a straight line. Sometimes when I just make bracelets, and I'll leave the pattern for this linked in the description as well, I also simply start with a straight line and then just do ties. I usually do this by taping off some string and then just starting in a straight line very carefully for that first row and then just continuing to do so, then removing the tape and making the ties after. I personally found that starting in a straight line has helped me because I tend to mess up the beginnings and it helps build your confidence in actually making the bracelet itself. And once you're fully confident with that, you can also go back and try to do some fancy ends, for which I also have a few tutorials on how to make triangle ends for alphas, loops, and so on. I'll leave that playlist in the description. But honestly, I've found that I prefer the straight start. It makes my bracelets look cohesive and I don't mess up the beginnings, which is really annoying. But if you do want to try fancy beginnings, I recommend starting with a straight line anyway and working your way up to that to build confidence in your actual bracelet making techniques. Another thing that I found helpful to just keep me in check is a ruler. I use this ruler a lot. I use it so much that it's cracked in multiple places. I might need to get another one. But I use this to make sure that my edges aren't slipping and that my rows aren't slipping. It's much easier to correct a mistake while you are making the bracelet rather than after. I use this ruler to make sure that each row is going exactly horizontally where I want it to be. I tend to compare it with the dowel at the top, but you can also just compare it with itself. I use the ruler to make sure that my edges are going straight down, and then if necessary, if I see a bit of a dip here, or maybe it pushes out a little bit, I then use my fingers to stretch that fabric out or push it in. I use it as I'm making the row to check if the row is going horizontally, and if not, I use that ruler to push the knots up or down depending on what I need to do. And then I also use the ruler to flatten the bracelet as I'm making it. And this works with both bigger bracelets and smaller bracelets as well. Definitely recommend using a ruler. Another thing that I found helpful is loosening up my knots. I didn't realize how tight my knots were and how much of an effect it was having on my work. When you pull your knots too tightly, it makes it difficult to maneuver them. Even with the ruler, it makes it difficult to push them up, push them down, push them to the side. And it also makes it so that you end up pulling too hard and it contracts. So I found that loosening up my knots has made it so that my bracelets are more cohesive, both with the edges and with actually making them, and it's easier to repair mistakes by pushing the knots to a side or to the top while I'm making the bracelet. That does require tons of practice though. Finding the perfect knot tension is something that we are all looking for and striving for, and it does require a lot of practice to figure out exactly how you should be making your knots, and there's not a shortcut there. This is something that you have to figure out for yourself with practice, unfortunately. But I believe in you. You can do this. This is very individual, so I can't give more concrete tips, unfortunately. Now let's talk about some things that affect your edges and just general mistakes that can happen in the bracelet as well. First of all, let's talk about the color switch, especially when you've got multiple colors switching. So I've got white, I just switched it to black, and now I need to switch it to red. This is all explored deeper in the flat alpha technique video, so if you want more details, you should look there, but I still want to give you a sort of brief look into how this works. The color that you are switching from goes up. The color that you have already switched, the white, gets pulled to the side and up as well, underneath the bracelet. You then retrieve the new color, and once you make the first half knot, you see that that knot ended up being pushed up a little bit, the black. It's pushed up. To fix that, I'm going to pull on the white string a little bit, just gently, not too harshly. I'm just gonna pull on it slightly to sort of fix that knot in place. I then put the black in between and close off the red with the second half of the knot. Sometimes when you do this, the previous color, in this case the black, is gonna sort of pop through a little bit. And you can see that that happens sometimes in the bracelet for me. I'm not always successful in fixing it, but to fix that, you take the color that you switched from, which is the black, and you gently pull down on the knot while maintaining the new string in the upwards position. You pull down on it, and thus, sometimes, not always, but sometimes it helps to get rid of that remaining color there. And then once you're done, this goes underneath and off to the side once again, and you continue with the color that you are working with. Once again, this is discussed more in the flat alpha technique video. So this is what the wall hanging looks like from the front. What does it look like at the back? It looks like a mess of string. So one thing that I personally find very important in making alphas is trying to keep the edges straight. And I feel like that's a common goal for a lot of people. So let's talk about it. What actually makes your edges go in or out? So I've discussed this a little bit already. Knot tension is pretty important, and I recommend loosening your knots to make them easier to work with. But it's not just that. It's also about the strings that you are using. Your strings in an alpha have to produce the same size knots, otherwise your rows are going to be uneven. Imagine what would happen if on this row, for example, one knot was smaller and the other one was bigger, then the next row will become wavy. You need to make sure that your strings are producing the same size knots. The best way to do this is to use the exact same brand of string, which is what I'm using here. This is all the same brand of string, just different colors. But if you're using different brands of string, I recommend trying a test bracelet first, where you're using that string on a maybe a smaller design. Try making a smaller alpha with those same strings and figure out if the knots that are being produced are the same size. If you are determined to work with different types of string that produce different sized knots, I wouldn't recommend this, but if you are determined, then on the smaller knots, try to make them looser so they end up bigger, whereas on the bigger knots, try to knot them tighter so they become smaller. But honestly, I would not recommend doing that. Try to find string that produces the same size knots. That will honestly help you. But what else? String pulling on itself can be a big factor in your bracelet contracting in size. And I've had this problem within this bracelet already. There are a couple of ways for you to counteract it, and I'm gonna go over them now. There might be some that I'm missing, but this is just what I do. See this string? I had this color string here. So for the shadow and then for the skin color, I had this string go from here to here, here to here. It was skipping over that black part a lot. And that ended up pulling, because whenever I have an issue of string pulling on itself, I tend to just sort of separate it with my hands and try to pull it out. But I can't do that if the string is pulling on itself. I just cannot physically pull it apart. So I cut it. I cut all of those pieces that were connecting, and then I pulled it. And now it's straight, before it dipped a little bit here. Not too much, but noticeable. I recommend using different strings, even if it's the same color, for different portions of the bracelet. It's up to you to decide where you want to do this, but typically I do this when I've got a portion of the color on one side, for example, the shadow here on the nose, and then the same color on the other side, for example, the ear here. Instead of dragging this string along this entire section, I just use two different strings. See, there's no dragging color here at all, even though you would think there should be, because it should connect, it's on the same row. But I used two different strings. I used one tiny string here because it's only a few knots, and then one longer string here for the same color. And I'm currently doing the same thing here. I've got two separate black strings, one of them here and one of them here. Now I still have the same color dragging along here. I probably should have used two separate white strings for this part. I might have to cut this through. I'm not quite sure yet, but I am using two separate black strings because I noticed that these colors are gonna go too far apart. So you can see here in my strings, I've got two black strings, one coming out from here and one from here. That helps reduce the dragging. And you can see that along the bracelet, I don't really have that much dragging. I had some here that I cut. I have a little bit here, but that's because there's a lot of color changes. And I have a little bit here because I didn't think about it. At the end, I probably should have. But generally, I try to reduce the dragging of string as much as possible, and that helps keep your bracelet straight as well. So once again, it's up to you to decide where you want to use multiple strings per color, but I recommend to reduce dragging as much as possible. So whenever you've got a big section, for example, here for the black, I might use one black string here and then another one here. Grouping these sections together, maybe one for these two and then one for these two. It all depends on you and how you want to do it, but I recommend using multiple strings, even if it is the same color. Remember the knot with me I mentioned at the beginning of the video? This is the knot with me that I was referring to while I was making this bracelet. Is actually the first time I sort of started figuring out these things. This has probably been known in the bracelet world before, I just only figured it out while I was making this. But let me show you this. There's still more information in that knot with me if you want to watch it, but I just want to showcase some parts here. So this is where I cut off all of the strings that was dragging across here, and that allowed me to sort of pull the side apart to make it more straight because it was constricting here a lot. And then you can see that there's a lot of background string that I kept cutting here because I kept dragging it across the entire thing. And same for the red. I probably should have used two separate strings for the red here, but I ended up not, and I ended up dragging it along all of the time, and that's why I cut it. But this is the bracelet. This is the wall hanging that I figured out that I don't have to do that. I can use two separate strings. So once I got to the bottom part here, I did use two separate strings for the background. I did use two separate strings for the outline color, for the green and for the white and for everything. I used two separate strings. And while it does look really messy, the only dragging here is in the center for these colors, which is not really avoidable. But I highly, highly recommend using separate strings. As for how I make the edges straight and not bumpy, I've mentioned this in a video before, but I think there was some confusion there, so let me go over it once again. Once you reach the end here, when I finally reach the end with my string, instead of doing a forward knot, because I'm going to the right, I'm making forward knots, instead of just doing a forward knot on the edge, I'm going to do a forward backward knot. And then the next row I'm starting, I'm going to have to go to the left in backward knots. But instead of doing a backward knot for the first knot of that row, I'm going to do another forward backward knot and then start with the backward knots. So when you go to the right, you do a forward backward knot once, and then you do it again for the next row. For the first knot of the next row, you again do a forward backward knot of whatever color you need, and only then you go to the left. Once you reach the end of the left row, you do a backward forward knot to the left and back. And then to start the next row after that, you're gonna do another backward forward knot with whatever color you need, and then you start the row forward. And that is how you keep the edges straight. Instead of doing forward knots or backward knots, you do forward backward and backward forward knot for the beginning and for the end of each row. But there you go. These are some of my tips that I have for making better alphas. These are just some tips that I have collected over the years. If you have more tips, feel free to leave them in the comments. I'm sure I and others will appreciate that. But I hope I could help you today. If you've got any questions as well, feel free to leave them in the comments. I'll try to answer as many as I can. And as always, the videos that I mentioned and the patterns that I showed today are all linked in the description for you to look at if you want to. But all that being said, I hope you enjoyed today's video. I want to give a special shout out to my patrons before I go, and especially my top supporters whose names are gonna appear on screen. Thank you guys so, so much for your support. It is with your support that I'm able to create these videos. And if you also want to become a patron and get exclusive perks for your donations, the link is in the description for you to sign up if you want to. But in any case, thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed today's video, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.